Trayvin. What words could describe Trayvin? Some may use words like rude, insensitive, or even asshole. But over the years, as I've gotten close with Trayvin, I've seen a different side of Trayvin. A side of him that's caring, sensitive, and very human. And that side of Trayvin is what I want to look into today. What better way to learn and understand Trayvin than to learn about the people he hangs out with and their relationship? So I asked all of his best friends some questions.
I've known him for like 5-6 years. He used to go to my church, but I've only really been friends with him for like this past year.
Doesn't he go anymore? When was that, when he went to your church?
I was like a third, fourth grade, so quite a bit ago.
I've known Trayvin since 8th grade. So I've been friends with Trayvin since 8th grade.
I've known Trayvin probably about like 5 years.
6th grade. And, I didn't really know him till like, probably 8th grade. And, I was kind of, I don't know, I never really hung out with him or anything. And I was honestly kind of scared of him. I don't know, he's just popular and I wasn't. But we went and hung out a couple times and he was pretty rad.
He, has changed a little bit because he tries to be cool. Yeah, he's wannabe. That's what he is.
Yeah, he used to, like, just make jokes, like innocent funny jokes. Like, he would see some, like, goose poop on the ground and be like, ha ha, and then he would just, like, laugh at it. But now he's, like, a little more edgy, a little more mature, I guess. Like, jokes that aren't as innocent.
He wasn't, like, he was an asshole then, now he's like a double asshole now.
100-pound difference, the fuck? Are you fucking kidding me? No, he's still a bitter piece of shit.
I don't really hang out with him a whole lot. I see him at school, and he eats lunch with me. We sit at the same table, but I don't really hang out with him.
I hang out with Trayvin about 3-4 days. I see him at school sometimes. But I don't hang out with him by choice, really. I want to hang out with other cool blokes. But Trayvin's not one of those cool blokes.
I would describe Trayvin like as pretty big. Muy grande. Muy guapo as well.
I would describe Trayvin as a silly feller. He's a silly feller. He, kind of a chunky boy. Really chunky boy. Like, extremely big. I'm friends with Trayvin because... Well, I'm not friends with Trayvin because he's not nice. He's funny. On occasion. When he's not racially motivated, but... He's not a good friend.
I'm not like great friends with him, but he's pretty funny. He's like, when you're in a big group of people, he's fun to be around just because makes a ton of jokes, makes everyone laugh, and just like brings the whole atmosphere up. I haven't seen a whole lot of his good side. I haven't gotten like super close with him, but one time when we were hanging out, we were just like all chilling, talking, and he started talking about like his life, I guess, like when he was younger and his home life, and that's like a side I've never seen before. I'm not sure if it's like his good side. We're just, like, getting to know him more, I guess.
I've seen his good side, if you know what I mean. When he was talking about his dad. Yeah. But other than that, no.
When was he talking about his dad?
When we were going to homecoming, he was talking about his dad to me.
We went to Avery Park, because it's right by our friend's, my friend Jack's house. And we went to go hang out with him, and me, Anthony, and Jack, we all got, like, distracted. And there was, like, this, like, cat, like, the stray cat, and he had a collar on and stuff. And we just got distracted. We were playing, like, a game of skate. And Trayvin, before he knew it, was sitting down with this fucking cat by the side of this river. And petting it for, like, 20 minutes. And he was, like, pretty worried about it. And he, like, wanted to call the owner and stuff and make sure that he was all right. So, yeah, that was pretty nice of him. Because he wouldn't call my parents if I was f***ing dead. Or, like, go to my funeral or, like...
In conclusion, Trayvin will always be in my memory as some funny kid who everyone hated. But that's the reason why me and my friends loved Trayvin. He wasn't trying to be cool, impress people, or popular. He was just trying to be funny, and he was being himself. But recently, this part of Trayvin, which we admired, has started to dwindle. And Trayvin, if you're watching this, I hope you know that we miss hanging out with you, and you've got some great friends who care about you.